Now let us come to the field of science and engineering where information technology is of immense importance. Okay, so this is also an important topic whenever we are considering the concept of, whenever we are considering the use of information technology. Okay, science and engineering field. See, the first thing we should be remembering here is, in order to perform complex scientific calculations, computers are being used. In order to perform complex scientific calculations or computations, suppose a person has designed a question, a person has designed a mathematical model, an equation based on that model, set of equation. Now, in order to solve those kind of complex scientific calculation also, the computers are required. Okay. Then one area is there which is called, two areas are there which are known as computer aided design and computer aided manufacturing. See, in suppose we are working in a mechanical organization, in a mechanical engineering department, in such situation we need to make a 3D models, we need to make 3D pictures of whatever the devices that we are going to design. Okay, in order to manufacture a particular end product, we need to make a design first, and that has to be done in 3D. Okay, three dimensional design should be there, and this can only be achieved by means of two of the most important tool, which is called CAD and CAM. Okay, computer aided design and computer aided manufacturing. Actually, both these are a courses in general, and it will take lots of time. Means interesting one, by means of which we can create 3D design of particular devices that are going to be built and that are going to be constructed and being added for making any automobile or making any machinery part. Okay, now apart from this, here we are using a term, simulating. What is simulating, we will discuss in our next. Before that, let us discuss the all of the points first. Okay, so these are the two important points in the field of science and engineering where IT plays a vital role, CAD and CAM. Then they are used for storing large amounts of data. As you might be knowing that by means of computers, hard disk drive and cloud storage, we can store large amounts of data in the computer by means of internet and computer. Then apart from this, fourth step is, computers are used for performing complex calculation. Okay, whenever there is a need to solve complex calculation, complex mathematical problems, in such situation also they are very much handy. Computers comes very much handy and will help us in doing so, assist us in doing so, and for visualizing 3D object. Now suppose a 3G object has to be created for a particular machinery, huge machinery. We need to create different parts, and those parts should be in 3D. Now, in order to visualize how it will look like, means whenever we will produce that particular 3D object, how it will look like, how it will be shown in front of us, how it will be produced, those pre-visualization can also be done. Pre-visualization before the actual model is being delivered can also be done by means of computers and information technology. Now, apart from these complex scientific applications such as rocket launching, space exploration are also possible due to the use of computers. We might have heard about Mission Mangalyaan, Mission Chandrayaan, all those things. In all those things also, in all those space exploration, rocket propulsion, there also the usage of computers and internet is very vital, very essential. Okay, so we need to, in order to perform all complex scientific applications, computers plays a vital role. This is about IT in the field of science and engineering. Now let us come to an important term which we discussed in our previous slide, that is simulating. What is simulation? What actually is a simulation? Now, whenever we would like to produce an image of the real world, whenever we would like to produce an image of the real model, real world in animated form. Okay, that is known as simulation. You might have gone through, you might have watched several movies which shows such kind of pictures. Coding is flowing in front of us, means it looks in real, but actually it is virtual world. Correct. So a simulation is an animated model. Now this is what it is, an animated model that mimics the operation of an existing or proposed system, means the system which is already there built, which is already there inbuilt. The simulation is just an image or a copy or a virtual environment of that particular system which is already present physically. Okay, a simulation is an animated model that mimics the operation of an existing or proposed system. So whenever we would like to imagine something which is for real, whenever we would like to imagine something, we would like to create an image of something in front of us which is in real, then that will be considered as simulation. Like the day-to-day operation of a bank, running an assembly line or assigning staff in a hospital or call center. Now you might have went through different operation that is being performed by a bank, so it is a kind of simulation. Okay, in the beginning they will design who will do all the duties in a particular day or in a particular week. They will allot them according to their need virtually by means of computer, and finally that all those duty that has been allotted to the party, to a particular candidate will be done. Okay, then running an assembly line, apart from this, assigning staff in a hospital or call center, all those things comes under the category of simulation. So this is also a very important part in our